Ceci, Deborah Sebon.
I greet everybody in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay. I would like to thank God for the opportunity Yahweh Magabobele to be able to return our teachings. Okay, the MLN people to settle down. Alright, before we can begin with our teaching, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time that you've given us to gather here to learn about academics and careers. Heavenly Father, we pray for our tuition to be able, oh God, to implement the Lotetanovarini lending. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you are our King and you have given us life and brains to be able, oh God, to just work and work willingly. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. Amen. Okay, first of all, before we can proceed with our teachings, I'd like to welcome my friends, Mr. and Mrs. Magoni in the house. Amen. I don't know what to tell them, but you can wave at the back. And thank you. Okay. As our lesson is about academics and careers, I want us to have building materials just jump from the Word of God. Amen. First of all, we'll be reading from Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. So we're going to Ibula and then we will read it. Elihumani, just say amen. Okay. All right. Yona, Kitari in King James, it says, commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. Amen. So let's proceed to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Okay. Yona, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. And then lastly, Colossians chapter 3, verse 23. Colossians chapter 3, verse 23. Okay, work willingly at whatever you do, as though you were working for the Lord rather than people. Amen. So the aim of the lesson is to talk to people, those who are like motivated before grade 10, and then those who are after grade 10, but then not to complete a matric, and those who have completed matric and then they're going to higher institutions, and those who are at higher institutions and they're going to the workplace. Alright, so for those who are basically in those grades before grade 10, I believe mostly maybe mochi in high school level. So if in high school level, or maybe if maybe kind of about primary, it's okay. But then we have to identify our interests. And when you identify your interests, it will be when you know what actually what are you passionate about. Because that is actually the beginning, if you are in that category. So when you have identified or again, what are your interests or what are you passionate about, then in those things you'll be able to determine your strength, your weaknesses, your opportunities, and your threats. So sometimes maybe not those people masala banyane things like that, but I believe what each and every one of us, we have something inside of us. Maybe we don't actually know what is it, but then when it is something that you're interested about, just imagine maybe you are a little boy, you're interested in cars, or you're a girl, you're interested in fashion, things like that. Then you just see yourself, oh no, you're into that mood, maybe looking at the television show, things like that. Only your interest. So when you identify your interest, then is this actually my my strength or my weakness or God put it or get ready now. And then when we have known all those above mentioned items, we'll be able to choose a right subject. Because when you open a grade 9 to 10, you are going to choose a subject. Most of us of mana, maybe you just choose, okay, now I'm going to science. Why? Because, well, my peers are into science. But you find out, no, man, I don't like science. You know, well, my gang is in there, and I feel like maybe that will study me. But then maybe you want to be in commercial. So, when you don't want to go there because I don't know anyone that you know. But actually, you need to know, in those things, when get to know actually what you want to do. Because those things, it out to shower, was after grade 10, you want to change the subject because you feel our eye, man, you gotta skip choosy right. So let's be able to identify our interest and in those things before we hit grade 10, we'll be able to know actually what kind of subjects do I want to do. Now, for example, I went to a technical high school. I knew what I wanted to do at an age, like roundabout, I think, either at grade 7. So I was just interested in what one of my breaches, gondi, remains, and things like that. Well, those people, Bastadisha, and then I know civil engineering. And I didn't know what is that thing. But then, okay, what is that? And then, Bano Kalu said in that manner. And then, I choose, okay, I want to go to a technical high school. And mind you, at first, I was in GA, well, because we are from Kizenikas, you know? And now, going to the technical high school, and then, I want to go there. Why? Because I want to do civil engineering. I didn't know much about it, but I wanted to do it. So, I knew I wanted to do technicals. And then, in grade 10, I just chose civil technology. Then, that's why I could not choose what I wanted to do. Amen. So, then when we proceed to those who were passing grade 10 and basically in high school phase before matric, honore, as you have identified or determined the career that you want to do, you have to look for the institutions that would have one of those things that you offer. So, when you identify those things, then I want to put the number, okay, actually, my goal is very clear. And those institutions, for example, if maybe you can visit libraries or even ask your teachers or internet for those who are accessible to internet, and then you can be able to know the requirements that career that you want them to. And then when you are in that process, you'll be able to work smart and hard towards achieving those things, because you know what, in maybe grade 11 you're going to be applying, and then what actually you want to go to which institution. Amen. And then when actually you pass that matric and then go into a higher institution, so at this level, because what I want you to borrow a plating about zero for in, and then now we proceed with your career. So when you proceed with your career, then now what I want you to borrow, okay, I'm at a level whereby I'm just closer to my goal or closer to my dream. So at this stage you get young adult. So you find what you are in, young adult, and then, well, maybe you never even had a thought of a business, things like that, when you just wanted to study and then find, graduate, things like that. So you find the worry, you're no longer having that one dream, I can say. You starting to develop the inside of you, and then you see what, okay, fine, I'm studying this thing. But in what I'm studying, something can be built. Or some people find the worry, maybe what they've done more high school, the modules or the subjects, they can be able to work with other things. It's not the worry, give one stream, but then you can be able to do other things. So you find the worry in that stage, we start to develop, okay, the mind, you start your own thing, and it happens. So, and don't find yourself worrying why dinner, yeah, that thing, maybe we'll be able to, okay, after this thing, fine, go find a work, things like that. So when you start to see what you develop a lot, so maybe because of people that now you'll be hanging around with, you know, allow those ideas to get back around. And then after you identify those things, so you have to understand the worry. As a young person, you have to be a risk taker. So you need to identify what kind of a risk taker are you. Are you maybe fine calculative in those risk of yours, or well, so you just need to identify the risk that you take. are you taking? And then when you proceed in your journey of being a young adult at an institution, you just know what, in whatsoever thing that you're doing, God will always be with you. And we shouldn't limit ourselves or we didn't things that now we not okay, they're developer. And then after you pass in your higher institution and to the workplace, well, you need to know what possible, maybe if you graduate and then work for someone, you need to know what there will be time whereby you work at a deadline and maybe your contract said, well, like 7 to 5, and you find what I honey, like now I can give example with myself. If I know okay, contract is not until 4:30, then you find the worry, you are in the middle of like a project and when you have something as in today, and today you are out with the like 4:30. So actually you need to push because Oliver is a deadline. So be willing to work an extra mile because as we have read, Mola Colossians, work willingly at whatever you do, as if you're doing it to the Lord. Amen. And then as you proceed to a higher institution, as you proceed to that higher institution or who really in the workplace, you must know what, be willing to learn in the workplace anywhere. Just go explore, go be that employee that you know what, okay, fine, this is my starting point. Because some people, yes, to start at, like, for example, a graduate, and then fine, you don't want to work for somebody, but then you just want to venture into a 21 or younger deal. And then some people are feeling like, now I'm not yet ready to just go into, I want, you know, the beginning, or I just want a startup, and things like that. So don't find yourself where you're so comfortable, all the things that you get there. What's the matter? Okay, maybe you have given yourself certain time, I'm going to work here for two years or whatsoever, and then I'm going to move into something that you know is within you. Amen. And then in that workplace, just know what again, when you are starting in that workplace, work in a way, yeah, worry. Lay low, say what they can even feel worry. No, there's someone, or I say, or maybe a kind of a secret or whatsoever. Then just know what actually, your presence means a lot to your company. Amen. Then after all those things that are schooling and so forth, just know what in the journey of academics, you need to know what again, your gift does wonders and it will bring you before men of importance. So just know what you know what God has given you. God understand what it can bring you to people that you never thought you would meet. And you know, don't find yourself what maybe you are young and then people that you're meeting give up a wound and you feel like, who am I? God, just know what God has ordained you and God has given you power. So don't be afraid of anything. God, just walk and understand what God is with you and he will never leave you. Amen. So let us know what again, God is our helper. So in everything that we do, let's seek him, let us understand what he is with us, and let us not be limited. So let us know what God is with us each and every time. And even our academics, because you know, academics and careers, they're able to maybe they go slowly but surely, maybe from God. Why? Because you find out you're so pressurized and you feel so tired. So if you don't set your time, I want to have quiet time with you, no matter how busy I may be in my workplace or in my business whatsoever. From God, because when you are focused on something, yes, it brings money, and yes, you're working willingly as you're working to the Lord. So just know what you still need that quiet time as you had maybe in varsity when pressure wasn't that much, and now you are in the workplace, pressure it's so much. So just know what you need to each and every time get close to God. And I believe what again, when you are born again, there is the Holy Spirit inside of you, and he can be able to guide you. What you know what now, your life is so busy, and when you leave time and end with God, so just come to God and you know, just renew what that love, yeah. and then we should be able to keep on learning, and we should be able when we meet people, visionary, you are a visionary woman, you are a visionary man. Be willing for it, and then what were actually, what are you talking about with those people? And then you find one in Josephila, wherever we are, and then you meet people that are bathing new things in you. Maybe, for example, you might be at the moment, maybe, or maybe entrepreneurship, it's not something in you. But you don't know about amazed, you meet with people that are about challenge, and then you start to see life in a different manner. So maybe sometimes you might be scared of, okay, in my family, something just so never happened. But then be that kind of a person, or this thing can start with me, and then you know what? God is with you at all times. Amen. So my lesson, so if we have questions, then we cannot see ya.
Okay, welcome back. Ntlha ya dithuto tsa maka ga wa challenge. Go pela go botsisha fa gore re ka thusa ba bjang re na sa leng sekolong re na le style sena sa gore skipa service ke pia ba ke kina ka go botsisha. Amen.
Okay. Before I answer that one, I want to leave any question. For me to be where I am, it is by the grace of God, and this grace of God shall sustain me. was going on, things like that. But still, I need to have time with God and fellowship with other brethren. Amen. Yeah, my sister, okay, if maybe you find yourself worried, we are from career to career, you just need to come to a point whereby you put in a stress or buzzer whatsoever. So with buzzer, obviously, but don't know, I just don't want to go to the first second chance or whatever. But then some little of minority are out of their company. So you need to have focus or okay, fine, give you capacity to do what? After here, what do I want to achieve? You know, because you need to know what. Yes, ugal unya go move to one place to another, but then kima wono our sponsor. You know, so just be able to uhono na amela ba tu. Leilo meva se family, ki company, ki NSFAS, ki whatever. But be able to na amela ba tu. Kure do to people what you want them to do to you. So when you're wasting well your time, maybe you don't care about your time. Mara, you're wasting someone's money. Yeah, so you fill them two hands if you want. Okay, you wanna tell me so in cloud, I think. Yeah. Okay, my hand, tell me.
Okay, tell me the show of the Melina Borman. Okay, in a little bit. I've got a question. I want to address this thing.